The first thing is Google My Business, right? Second thing is LinkedIn. Third, Facebook. Fourth, Instagram. Fifth, YouTube. Sixth, Twitter. And seventh, Pinterest. I'm going to start with the first two being LinkedIn and Google My Business, because I think these are the most basic must-haves for everybody who has either physical location, and if you are a service person, if you do not have a LinkedIn profile, you're not saying anything. I went to courts and I brought a whole home gym set and set it up in my house, and I was trying to figure out how to get protein. I went on Google and I clicked search buy protein powder, and the first thing that popped up was this store called Fitness Junkies JA. I clicked on it, I looked on the pictures, I said, oh my God, these guys have so much protein. I must go to this store. I've never heard of this place unless I found it on Google. The owner himself, he works there. He set this thing up himself. That thing that he did, he set this up, what, 2 years ago, just being on Google, and I would have never ever found him unless it was there. Second thing, let's talk about LinkedIn. So I'm just doing the basics. Yes, most people are not taking advantage of LinkedIn. And the best thing we can do for ourselves is look professional on our LinkedIn, which is to take that time, that one day, to write that description. If you have a son or your daughter, please ask them to read it and to say, does this reflect what you think of me? Right? Is this how good I am? And it's going to make a huge, huge difference. LinkedIn, for service professionals, that works excellently. It's going to help you create a track record. It's going to allow you to be able to, get extra clients. You're way ahead of the person who has no profile. So that's the first two things. LinkedIn and Google My Business are not active things. You don't have to be managing it every single day. You can just one and done it. Set it up once. You don't have to put any more skills, but you're there. It's going to help you. This show happens on Facebook, right? And this show at max maybe might get 40 to 100 live viewers, but afterwards it goes to 40,000 to maybe 100,000 people in Jamaica alone watching the show. That just shows Facebook is very relevant. Facebook has 1.6 million users every single month in Jamaica alone, right? Instagram only has 800,000. And so Facebook is still way more active than Instagram. Instagram is definitely good if you have a visual business. So anything that can be shown to say better. So I'm a roofing company and the roofs look better. If I'm paving things and the paving looks better, right? Or if I'm a car body shop and the cars look better, anything that looks better. Now, a lawyer is going to have a hard time on Instagram because, a lawyer is not naturally visually appealing. So you probably have to hire a consultant to make it look cool. You can't necessarily transit all types of businesses to Instagram unless you're a big corporate, you have the money to think through it. There's a guy named Andre Eats or Andre Cooks, something like that. He has a restaurant somewhere, but I saw his pictures and the food looks so great. This is just from Instagram. Right? Mm-hmm. If he wasn't posting these visual things, I would not know about him. That's how you get customers. You start to post visual things, right? If you could share interesting tidbits. Now, this is where YouTube is really big. YouTube is a place for businesses. If you can share information that doesn't necessarily can benefit me, even if I don't come and buy from you, that's what's going to work. I could never speak to so many people at the same time. I just don't have the capacity. I can't mentally engage. It's not possible. But in this video that me and Rochelle are doing together, I'm here, when it's cut up and put on Facebook or YouTube later and 10,000 people watch it afterwards, 10,000 people are going to feel like they know me. They know me, Craig Powell. They might say hi to me. They'll say, I want to do business with you because I'll seem like a nice guy. I'll seem intelligent and I've added value to your life, even though I haven't sold you anything. And the amount of time it took me was only 30 to 40 minutes. So that's what YouTube does. It multiplies your best salesperson. It multiplies your technique. Everybody can do it. We can do it with our phones now, right? It doesn't even have to be the most high quality production. Just do something short and you'll be surprised at how many people will find you and they will do business with you. But to be good at this, you have to be either consistent or you have to be willing to leave something. And I would say for people who are not necessarily doing like a beneficial thing to somebody, you can actually still share an experience. And it has to be driven by a talented, somewhat not boring person. Remember, people are going to be watching you for 5 minutes. So you have to engage. Okay, so quickly, because everyone always asks me, should I go on it? Very hard for you, for businesses to be successful on Twitter. Twitter is very heady. It's a very engaging thing. The people who are on it are looking for content that is very relevant to them. The only companies that I've seen do it very successfully are essential services that everyone has to be involved in. Flow, Digicel, as well as, JPS. All the banks are going to be able to maintain following, even if they're not interesting, because you have to hear from them. But if you're a small business, it's gonna be very, very hard for you to actually, you know, keep engaged unless you have a super smart, savvy person. Now, all other platforms, Pinterest, other things of that nature, not necessary. The main ones that I've said, which is Google My Business, LinkedIn, have to. Facebook, have to. Instagram, depending on your type of business, Twitter, very, very hard. But if you do those three, guys, you're good. Now, this is very, very important. Most people in Jamaica, we have crap websites. We just do. I'm sorry to say that, we do. So the competition isn't just what is in the country, it's actually what's overseas, which means that we have to actually be a little bit different in building our websites, right? There's two types of websites that I've seen. Proper ones, which are more expensive, you're looking at anywhere between $400,000 minimum to about $1.3 million, which I'll explain why that is the case. And Foolishness, which is anywhere from, you know, $50,000 to $100,000 or $200,000. And finally, the very good do-it-yourself. I spent some time, or my son who is very interested, or my daughter who's into, my niece, who is interested, building a website on Wix, one page website, right? If you don't actually want to do any of this, remember to just register your name on all platforms. Please do that.